State officials have ordered a local funeral home closed after dozens of bodies were found stacked in bags. Good evening, everyone. It's our big story tonight at 6. That funeral home and two morticians have had licenses revoked after those bodies were found.
Officials have ordered those bodies be cremated and the funeral home then shut down. 11 News reporter George Lettuce is live in our studio tonight with more on that story and what he has learned about how the state inspects these businesses. George.
Well, Marianne, the Chambers Funeral Home in Prince George's County has been operating for nearly a century, but now it's fighting to stay in business following a shocking discovery.
Late last month, a surprise state inspection of the Chambers Funeral Home and Crematorium in Prince George's County uncovered something much more surprising. As many as 40 corpses waiting for cremation piled up in a garage in body bags.
We made a slight error in judgment within that performance, and we're trying to rectify this through our attorneys.
The inspector's report also details fluid leaking from the body bags, creating a pungent odor and outrage from state officials.
This is a company that's been around for a while, and second generation. And people entrust their loved ones to them, their children, their mothers, their fathers.
Harry Close, president of the Maryland Board of Morticians and Funeral Directors, says it routinely inspects funeral homes. But 11 News has learned there's only one inspector responsible for the state's roughly 500 funeral homes. And inspections happen once every 2 years. Up until 2009, they happened every year. It's why Close, who runs a funeral home, says family members should do their own records research.
I have family members that ask me, do I have a website? And they go on my website and they ask me questions before they make a decision they want to serve. Have us serve them.
Coincidentally, days after the Chambers discovery, Governor O'Malley signed new laws giving the state more power to inspect crematories.
I think with the establishment of minimal operating standards and procedures, hopefully an incident like this would never occur again.
Chambers Funeral Home has until Friday to cremate the bodies and then close down indefinitely as the state continues this investigation. In the studio, George Lettuce, WBAL-TV 11 News.